someone had really torn the place up. If it had been LPD, the real LPD, they would have confiscated the entire stash. Instead, Izzo's off-world weaponry was still there, but all the police-issue firepower was gone.
Your floor number, please.
McCoy, 88F.
88. Thank you.
Where's Maggie? Where's my animal?
Step off, mofo. Ain't no Maggie here.
She was here last night when I left.
You got the wrong place, Jack.
Hey, man, I live here.
I don't know what you're speed loading, and I really don't care.
Wait a minute.
I got no problem icing you if that's what you want, Jack.
Your floor number, please.
Private property.
Hey, haven't I seen you somewhere before?
Always chasing. That your name? Jason, got that big dumb lox out the back of the sushi bar, remember?
Small world, ain't it?
I guess so. And again, I ain't the one standing in your living room.
You said another one when I came down the elevator.
Not a lot of people. Artificials.
How'd you know they were replicants?
Are you kidding? I can spot a skin job at 100 paces in the dark.
Describe them to me.
Sure you don't got that drink?
Maybe later.
Well, there's the Japanese guy with the coat and the glasses.
Skinny guy, blonde hair, ponytail?
Yeah. And the guy with the muscles and the funny hair.
Dreadlocks?
Right, I've seen him twice. And the two-headed guy, the fat man.
Fat man? The one I was chasing from the sushi bar.
Nah, the other fat man. You know him, rough voice, always eating.
How many times have you seen the fat man down here?
Bunch of times. Last time weren't that long ago.
What was he doing?
Collecting guns like always.
Handguns? A blaster like mine?
Handguns, rifles, a whole armful. Took them through that gate. Dumped them in the sewer. You're gone now. You sure you ain't got nothing to drink?
Can you describe him?
Yeah, rough guy. Barks out orders a lot. Everybody listens when he's around. A natural.
Let me ask you something.
Cooked it be. Damn tasty.
I'm talking to you here.
Bring the licking gun.
Let me ask you something.
Cooked it be. Damn tasty.
I'm talking to you here.
Bring the licking gun.
What's your strongest?
Purple?
Set it up to go.
What do you want, a to-go cup?
How about a flask?
Cost you extra. You get caught with an open container on the street, ain't my problem.
It's for a friend. Still thirsty, pal?
Mucho obligato, senor.
Stay with me for a minute, pal. About that Batman you saw.
Your kid.
Huh?
No, you're his kid. That's what it is.
How's that?
Hell, I seen you guys together 3 weeks ago at the speech. You remember?
I remember it all right. Half the LPD had special duty that weekend working the security detail for Governor Kolvig's speech, and Guza had been the lieutenant in charge. A little light started to flicker in my brain. Guza was the one measuring me for the frame. The homeless guy only confirmed my worst suspicions. The picture was still a little blurry. Guza must have had some connection to Clovis and his group, even though he always claimed to have hated replicants. He wouldn't have helped out any skin jobs unless they had something really juicy to lord over him. Disgusting. Disgusting.
No, no, we tried that already. Look, we know that the adenine thymine and guanine cytosine sequences can be mutated in progress. Let's move on.
Hey, it's about time you showed up.
You know who I am?
Detective Ray McCoy. You're investigating Miraji's death.
And Eisendollers.
Having any luck?
You're Luther and Lance?
Hell of a smart cookie there.
Take your guns and your violence elsewhere. We've got important work to do.
The reps that killed Marcus and Miraji, they'll be looking for you.
You're a little late, Detective. They've already found us.
So why are you still walking around?
Because we're all part of the same suit of cards, you know what I mean? Eldon makes mistakes just like any other human. The difference is...
The difference is your bastard doesn't like to admit it.
No, he covers them up, pretends they're human, gives them a job at a stinking corporation, and then when they actually produce original work, he boots them out on the street.
You're saying you're replicants?
We finally figured it out. Clovis helped us see the light.
But that's ridiculous. Tyrell wouldn't design something like you. He wants perfection.
I told you we were a mistake.
Keep talking.
Sometimes our memories are... different from each other's. The implant process isn't perfect. We know, we've seen the studies. You can't always be sure exactly how the memories will play out in the subject's mind.
We've got different recollections of our childhood. Explain that.
Maybe one of you just forgot.
If you can't trust your own memories, what's left that makes you human?
What are you doing down here?
Eldon shafted us, so now we're returning the favor.
We promised Clovis we'd be finished with this by the time he got back, so if you don't mind...
Tyrell says the 4-year lifespan can't be extended.
Of course he's gonna say that, but he's wrong. Very wrong. We got the research right here that'll prove it.
Is it complete? Could you extend the life of a replicant right now?
Well, no. The 4-year limit is an integral part of every element of the replicant. Tyrell's dictate was that every body part would fail, and only the designers of each would know exactly how it worked.
Clovis has already unlocked the secret of the skin. That was Miragi.
Sebastian and Chu, they'd know about the central nervous system and the eyes. A lot of retrograde viruses were built into the eyes.
And Tyrell, he's got the basic DNA pattern information, but he won't just give it up.
Did you tell Clovis all this?
He didn't ask. He already knew. He knows all about you, too.
Where's Clovis now?
Gone to have a little heart-to-heart with Eldon.
He'll kill Tyrell if he gets to him.
Isn't that just too bad?
I won't shed any tears. Tyrell is killing us all. 4 years isn't enough, is it?
If Clovis snaps his neck, it'll be merciful and quick. That's a hell of a lot more than we've been given.
I got a little test I want you to take.
You believe this clown? He wants to void Comfus.
Sorry, McCoy. Shoot us or leave us alone. Let's get back to work.
Clovis set me up, didn't he? And he used my boss to do it.
He's sharp, this one.
No question.
Tell me what you know.
How about we trade?
Our life for yours.
Keep talking.
Clovis has gone to see Eldon.
But he might not make it.
Still, the work will go on, with or without Clovis. Get us Tyrell's files, the rest of the DNA data, and we'll help you.
You want me to break into the Tyrell building for you? You're nuts.
Defective, yes. Nuts, no. You need us, McCoy. We can serve up Guz's carcass on a big, oversized platter.
What kind of deal did you have going with Runciter?
Don't talk to me about it. That was Lance's stupid deal.
We just wanted to make some extra cash on the side.
That probably had something to do with you guys getting fired.
I'm sure he wasn't too pleased.
Since Eldon's such a pain-in-the-ass control freak.
Did you meet Clovis through Runciter?
It was all just a coincidence.
Stick around. I may not be finished with you.
Hey, stop!
I think I got what you wanted from Tyrell's office.
Check it out, bro. The little man with the big gun did good.
A bargain's a bargain. You said you'd give me Guza.
It's all right here.
Your boss is a real piece of work, let me tell you. Almost as good as Tyrell. Take a look.
That probably had something to do with you guys getting fired.
Guza had his fingers in as many rancid pies as possible. He was insatiable. He sold police equipment, ripped off criminals, and he even killed. And here were documents that proved it all. Depositions, photographs, video discs. It was the complete file on Guza, the dirty cop.
Where'd you get this?
From Clovis. He told us to hold it for him.
Come to think of it, I'm not sure you're supposed to see it. You want to give it back now?
Not a chance.
Let him have it. Clovis said he was finished with the policeman anyway.
Been messing with people's lives lately?
McCoy, where the hell you been? We've been looking all over for you.
Yeah? Am I wanted dead or alive?
You don't know what you are.
You can sell that replicant shit to everybody else, but I ain't buying.
If you're so clean, let's put you on the machine. That'll decide once and for all.
I'm through listening, Guza. Now it's your turn. I've been doing some investigating on my own. Came across some prime sources. You know what I'm talking about. Those little illegal weapons deals with Ezo. You were raking in the Chinyan, selling LPD wares to scumbags and reps. Oh, yeah. The department's gonna eat it up when they hear just how deep that corruption goes.
That's a load of crap.
Let's hope for your sake Bryant and the brass feel that way when I lay this file on them. Otherwise, it's a one-way ticket to the off-world penal colony, fat man.
What do you want, McCoy?
Remove the frame, clear my name, and get that guy out of my apartment. I want my life back.
I can't do that.
You better start finding a way, because I got another call to make.
Okay, okay. How do we work this out? Can't talk on the damn phone.
The sewers. I know you want to be comfortable, and I figure it's kind of like your second home down there. At the bottom of the old elevator, there's a gate. Past it, there's a chamber. It's got a round platform.
Yeah, I know it.
Be there, alone. You better hold up your end, or Bryant gets it all. Did you get that asshole out of my apartment?
It's cleaner than when you left it.
My dog?
Yeah. Yeah, your pooch is there too.
That everything I need to clear me?
I gotta tell you, kid. Those insect bottles look pretty real.
Let me guess. Clovis gave them to you.
It must seem pretty gullible, but he sounded on the level. He called you his brother. Said you came down in the moon bus with all of them. He said Tyrell was using you to get inside the LPD. You hadn't been on the job too long, so I thought, maybe.
You'd screw with my head? How convenient. You could satisfy your blackmailer and keep me from sniffing around your dirty work at the same time.
You're too smart for me, kid. Water under the bridge. You ready to talk trade?
I got it all right here. Photos, files, discs, the work. It ain't a pretty sight.
You can't blame a guy for trying to better himself.
Trying is one thing. Ripping off speed loaders and selling the shit yourself? Farming out LPD weapons through black marketeers? Torching two pimps who wouldn't pay you off when you were working vice?
Hey, those two had it coming.
How long did you think it could last?
It finally reaches the point where you don't even think about what happened yesterday. Only what's coming to you tomorrow. 20 years in the job, kid, and nobody was gonna touch me.
Helping reps also part of the job?
I was gonna whack them myself once the heat was up. Tie up those loose ends.
Once I was out of the way.
Clovis is still gonna come gunning for me, kid. You and Chris gotta take him down. Then my problems are over. Our problems are over. And we can all live happily ever after.
I don't know. A lot has changed. I don't know what I want anymore.
That's fine, kid. Just walk away. I knew you didn't have the cojones.
Hey, I got you where I want you, don't I?
Kid, I'm what they call a survivor. I've crawled through the sickest sludge of hell and lived to tell the tale. I'll be around long after they've forgotten that you were ever on the job.
Wouldn't bet on it.
But I'm tired, kid. I'm ready to turn over a new leaf. I swear to you, everything will be different if we just stick together. Mop this thing up. Come on. What do you say?
I see we were right to follow him, Sadiq.
Looks that way, Ma.
Who the hell do you think you're getting, McCoy? You're gonna fry!
The hunter? He do us a favor, Ma. He bagged us a traitor.
Brother, you killed a human. There's no going back now.
Come out and show yourselves.
First things first. You must...
Stop calling me that!
You've wasted much precious time already. No more choices, Ray McCoy. Meet us at the moon bus. Together we will face the tigers that wait in the night's forest.
Tough day, McCoy.
You could say that.
Steele is looking for you, and Bryant. You've been keeping the whole department hopping, you and Guza.
I know. You looking for me too, Gaff?
Looking, not killing. I'm in a good mood today. You know you got some interesting neighbors, McCoy.
Yeah, well, I've been too busy to visit lately.
You gonna turn yourself in?
I'm thinking about it.
Think hard. You killed anyone yet? It's like I said before. You retire a human, your career is over. Your life too, maybe. But we don't live forever, do we?
So I say, well, you should have voted for him then.
Very good. Very funny, yes. Governor, let's get down to business. At last estimate, 5 billion tons of kipple surround this city. Eventually, it's going to have to be cleared away.
Elgin, we've got specials to do that job.
But the attrition rate is enormous. No, no. There's only one way it can be accomplished. My way.
Unfortunately, your way is illegal.
For the moment, yes. But laws can be changed. And if replicants were allowed to work on Earth, imagine what your legacy would be. Governor Maurice Kolvig, the national hero who eliminated toxic debris. Even your opponents will vote for you.
How can you possibly guarantee that no tragedies will occur?
It's a very simple solution to an old design challenge. Give them jobs on Earth, and they will never desire a different life.
That is a lie.
Who's there?
It's one of my children, I think, and a very resourceful one at that. Why don't you show yourself?
With pleasure.
Call security.
Who is this man?
I'd like to ask the same question.
One more word from him, and he'll be dead.
I will not be spoken to!
You're certainly a man of your word.
I want all the data you have on replicant DNA structures, the mutation studies, everything.
Why don't you just take a seat? We'll have a little talk.
I don't have time for talk.
I wish I could help you. I really do. But the data is useless. The 4-year lifespan is unalterable.
My friends, my family, dying before my very eyes, and all you can say is, there is no hope.
Time is precious, my son, and you have been keeping yours well.
And when night comes, I'll go to place fit for woe. Walking along the darkened valley with silent melancholy.
I would prefer him alive if possible. Not exactly the conclusion I had in mind. Have you stationed guards in the mezzanine?
Yes, sir, but, I mean, after the fall...
Oh, don't be a fool. He's not dead yet. His time hasn't come.
Maggie! Come here, girl!
Pick up.
Where you been, Slim? The boys told me you were kicked hours ago.
My dog is still missing.
Cut the crap about the dog, okay? I got something that'll really rev your engine.
I'm all ears.
I got a line on where the skin jobs are hauling up.
Not the Yukon?
Yesterday's news. Remember Gav was talking about that moon bus massacre? I found out where they crash landed at. 5 will get you 10, they'll be licking their wounds there.
Excellent. Where do we go?
How about moi? Here's a hint, Slim. It's way the shit out there in the kipple. Way, way out.
How are they getting into the city?
They've been accessing through an old sewer tunnel.
We gonna air out the reps together or what?
I'm liking your style more and more. First come, first serve. I share my bonuses with nobody. See you on the other side, Slim. Your floor number, please.
Ground floor.
About time you got here.
If I was a Nexus 6, you'd be dead.
No, you'd be dead. I heard you stumbling around back there 10 minutes ago.
I got a little hung up. Where's the moon bus?
Real close. You ready to take care of business?
Hell yeah.
There's gonna be a hot time in the old town tonight. I don't like it. It smells like ambush territory. Always hated closed spaces.
Hold on. I'll get an ambulance out here.
Oh, I screwed the pooch this time, Slim. I promise. You'll waste Clovis. I taught you pretty well, didn't I?
Maggie! Come here, girl! Come on!
Here you go, baby. Dinner time.
Could they?
Oh, God. No.
You like my present, ma?
You bastard! She was an innocent!
She a big ma. A machine, like you. Tyrell, you make her more doggy than dog, you know?
That's a lie!
You don't remember it, I'm thinking. None of it. Them false memories. They really want you good.
Come on out and show yourself, you coward!
I've been expecting you.
I see Steele didn't make it.
I could have used you about 10 minutes ago.
You didn't need any help, McCoy.
Chief Bryant wants to talk to you. He says you're really ready now.
It never ends, does it?
Uh-uh. You're a real Blade Runner now. Full retirement bonuses and everything. You've done a man's job, sir.
How come I don't feel good about it?
Who knows? Buy yourself another animal, maybe. A real one, not a Tyrell fake.
She wasn't fake.
Whatever you want to believe, McCoy.